us on the cleaning side because there's less to clean up, but also from a human level, it gives people some basic dignity. And we're very proud of the fact that we've been able to clean up the neighborhood quite a bit in the past year and a half. So, yeah, that's it.
Wow. And they kind of take a life of their own, and when a new person takes the lead, executive director takes the lead, but understands, he's new to the neighborhood, but he still understands and gets good grasp on what is needed, and not just as some of the other previous executive directors, not naming which ones, they end up being hired from within the agency, and they're not trained, they don't understand what it is to be an executive director, or they're like a property owner or something, and they got the job, and they're not maybe doing the correct oversight of the organization. Whereas you came from, I don't know where you came from another location to be already, and you see such a new job in comparison, and so I really applaud the board of directors for doing that marvelous. Which you actually are doing it the right way, and that's what I think. That's really why you're being chosen, is because you're doing it the right way.
Thank you.
And
first one was Court Mayor of San Francisco. Second. Senator Scott Wiener. Yeah. And Bill Tanger. And all 11 Board of Supervisors.
And you said you have such big arms that this one you're up with. This one's like, you just get sick on your
arm. It's looking the right size for you. That was
exactly. Now you probably thought you were going to get A award, correct?
I did.
Yeah, you probably received. Yeah, and so and that's why when people kind of we realize that we're not going to have the ability to do this over and over again, so we want to do one hit run and really give it to who feels the star of the community, and this is how we want to do that. Recognize our stars, why you're still stars. That's why Todd Carter, he's still happy that you can get in touch, and some of the other people will be recognized because they're stars, and we want to recognize them in a very proper way. And so we like to, we're going to be coming into your office one of these days. I've seen people, they punch through the whole wall, or business owners have their, and I tell them sometimes to make copies, don't put the originals out if you're a business owner, but people will try to tag them or something.
One last thing, I would be remiss if I didn't thank my wonderful ambassadors, my staff, who are actually out there every day from 6 to 6 cleaning up all sorts of things you don't want to talk about.
WPC, correct. And I also should thank you.
And my board of directors.
For employing you.
Yes. Thank you very much.
Yes.
So they can go home to their families and rest up or check on their families. So we have all the functions of a police officer, except we don't carry guns. We carry guns. So I'm going to accept the police honors, I guess, award for those guys, since their lieutenant's not here. And then I'll pass it on to him at our meeting we have Monday morning. So.
The award, and this went for the records, and then shortly after this, not only leave, we want to take a group picture of all you guys to show you showed up too. Lieutenant David Falzon of the Alcohol Beverage Control Liaison Unit, Samson Police Department, in recognition for the alcohol industry community education and public policy. Basically, he's the head of the department that approves liquor licenses for the City and County of San Francisco. So he's kind of the gatekeeper between San Francisco and the state. So he says, who gets the liquor licenses, and how do you put the conditions on them, and how do it involve the community, as well as the police, as well as planning? In other words, he's one of the arms before an approval happens on a liquor license. And at the Board of Supervisors, there's one committee that listens to his recommendations on a regular basis from his department, and adds those conditions, or and maybe additional ones to a license before they're approved, so that they are meet the needs of the community. So it's a very important job, and I think that he's done a very good job. He's not feeling well, that's why he's not here, and I couldn't get a substitute police officer, even though we were promised to show up, but that's okay. And so he obviously gets the same pile of awards, and we will get them to him. So could all the honorees come up, because we have a camera person to recognize you, because we're here. service providers. So, with that, Dennis is going to start doing something with the food, making sure everybody gets some food, because one of the best parts is eating and socializing, and everybody has name tags, so you should know your neighbor. We do have a donation can out and a business card container out. They were off to the side. So if anybody wants to donate, that's fine. But plenty of food. I think we didn't expect as much food, but plenty of food. Stay, because we actually have this place until 9 o'clock in the afternoon, then starting at 6. So, and it's going to change. The second event's even more famous. That's why we have the camera. So,
the mission. So we shot for the hospitality house. And our office is used to be over on the Stone Commission Collective. So I heard this really well right across the street.